Coming up on EOP News, few Panthers know of the heated relationship brewing between Dr. Coleman and Mr. Engel. We find out more about these two and their inseparable friendship.
Plus, we show you some self-defense techniques that no textbook could ever teach. All that and more coming up on Eye of the Panther News. And welcome to Eye of the Panther News. I'm Taylor Gillette.
And I'm Ryan Takamura. Yesterday, the Willenberg Special Education School visited the Peninsula campus for the annual holiday exchange program. The two Willenberg buses arrived in front of Peninsula High's gym right before third period, and two Peninsula students paired up with each Willenberg student, showing them around campus. Towards noon, these students made their way back to the lunch tables, which was provided for all participants. Peninsula students filled the gym during lunchtime to see the heartwarming performances that the Willenberg students put on.
Did you have fun this year?
Yes! I had a lot of fun!
Well, it's just really nice to see like kids, even though they have to face challenges, that they can come and perform and make us all happy and smile, and it just makes me feel good.
After lunch, the Willenberg students said goodbye to the Panthers as they headed to the bus to go back home. It was really an amazing event. We will have a full recap of next week's exchange when we go to Willenberg on Wednesday.
Thanks, Ryan. The new year's coming up, and if y'all are planning on going out, especially you ladies, we have some tips for you to stay safe this holiday season.
There are lots of safety precautions that you should use every day. Always use the buddy system, park near lights at night, and always be aware of your surroundings.
Well, I would never get in that situation because I'd always use the buddy system, so I'd always be with somebody.
I would poke him in the eye or jump on his back.
I would run and scream and kick and get away as fast as possible.
You can use anything on you as a weapon. Makeup, keys, if you have a car, use that. Anything near you, you can use it. And it's just really important to most of the time be with somebody so they can help you.
Here are some strategies and techniques that you can use if you are ever in a dangerous situation. Hitting. Using pepper spray. Using the buddy system. Having a bodyguard.
Don't worry, ladies, I got you.
Just the small things you should know, like don't walk in the dark alone. Always go with a buddy somewhere. You should know these things already, but it's really important to do in case the situation actually happens.
Keep these safety tips in mind. They might come in handy. I hope you all have a fun and safe winter break. Ryan?
Those are some very nice tips, Taylor. Thanks a lot. On a separate note, two teachers here on the Peninsula campus are bound by a historic rivalry, one way too complex for the average student to understand. Well, what the heck is going on between Dr. Coleman and Mr. Engel? Coleman and Engel first clashed during the Halloween of 2002 when they inadvertently wore the same costume. Since then, it has been a constant struggle for teaching superiority between the two. Timothy Coleman is a bald ex-veteran with a degree from Chico State and a PhD from Wayne State, and presently, an English and AVID teacher. Christian Engel is a part Chilean badminton playing graduate of Georgetown and Johns Hopkins, and also an English and AVID teacher. Generally, who is the better teacher?
Oh, well, I think there's no doubt about it. I am. Mr. Engel, besides the bad personal hygiene and the other things, I don't really even think they do anything in that class. I sometimes walk by and I see that his kids are doing nothing. They're playing games. He's got his long Australian thing out. I don't even know what's happening in that room, but it doesn't look like work is going on.
I've heard the typical comments that I've heard from students leaving Coleman's classroom are, oh God, that was so boring. Why was he yelling at us so much today? I just don't think that's the way we should teach.
My kids, on the other hand, I'm like a slave driver. We had 15 essays this month, and I think we'll probably have another 15 next month. I'm up until 2, 3 every night working. Sometimes I will call Mr. Engel at like 8 o'clock at night, and, hey man, are you grading papers? And he's so incoherent, I don't even know if he knows who he's talking to.
When I look at my classroom, I look at it as a garden that needs care and nurturing. I use the education that I got at Georgetown University to teach the kids something that they really not only would benefit from, but would become enlightened by.
The recent controversy with the president and whether or not he was American made me think of Mr. Engel, because I've actually not seen a birth certificate saying that he was born in this country. And it's not a problem if he's Chilean. I mean, he should be proud of his Chileanness. I just think he should be open with people. It's pretty obvious that he's not an American citizen.
I do find that part of his bitterness and anger towards the world is that he lost his hair very early on in life. And as you can tell, I still have a full head of hair.
In your honest opinion, who would win in a fight, Coleman or Engel?
Well, right off the top of my head, I would take Coleman. Unless Mr. Engel showed up with his didgeridoo, and in which case, he's pretty agile with that thing, and I think he would win the match at that point.
Ryan, I'm pretty sure that Mr. Engel would win. I'm pretty sure, yeah. Mr. Engel for sure.
Well, I think the answer is obvious. I think it would be Coleman, given the fact that in the midst of a confrontation, the reflection, this is pure physics, the reflection off of his head would distract Engel, giving Coleman the upper hand.
Both teachers were able to put their strengths to the test in an annual event that they've done for the past 3 years, a bike ride to support multiple sclerosis awareness.
Well, I think we both agree that I won, but he thinks it's because I shoved something in his spokes and he went over the top.
I don't think it's legal for you to take your bike pump and shove it into between the spokes of the competitor's bicycle wheel. That, I think, was what stopped me from beating him in the race.
The truth is that I actually drafted behind one of Mr. Engel's calves for the last half of the race. I couldn't get behind him, all of him, but I could get behind just one of his calves. And that provided actually enough drafting space for me and several trucks behind me.
You may have not noticed their heated relationship, but that's the beauty of it. A lasting rivalry is a special thing, one that, at times, is concealed from the public eye. This is Ryan Takamura, EOP News.
Those two have a very interesting relationship. Thanks, Ryan. Tickets are on sale now in the student store for the winter choir concerts going on December 15th and 16th at 7 o'clock p.m.
Palos Verdes Peninsula's choir presents Sounds of the Season, the 2009 choir concert. We caught up with Dan Doctor to find out more information.
This year's winter concert is going to be held at a new venue for us. This is at Rolling Hills United Methodist Church. It's a beautiful place to hold a concert. We're really looking forward to it. We're going to have four different choirs singing, kind of different varieties. There'll be a lot of classic holiday songs that you're used to hearing and some songs that maybe you're not used to hearing. We're really looking forward to having a really nice show. This place holds a lot more seats than the PAC does, so we really need to try to sell some tickets. So we'd love for you guys to come on out. Again, it's the 15th and 16th, next Tuesday, Wednesday at 7 p.m. And tickets are $3 for middle school, $5 for high school students with an ASB card, and $7 for all adults. You can get tickets at the door or right here at the student store. We definitely hope to see you all there. Thanks.
That's just about it for EOP News, but before we go, we have a few reminders.
This Sunday's performance of The Odd Couple will be the last. Tickets are in the student store. Don't wait, they're going fast.
Attention seniors, get your Grad Night 2010 ticket from the student store before the price increases. The venue is a surprise, but the DJ from Power 106 will be there.
Newspapers are being distributed just about right now, so pick one up before you leave school today. And don't forget to wear your festive holiday sweaters next Thursday.
Thanks for watching EOP News. I'm Ryan Takamura.
And I'm Taylor Gillette. Have a great weekend, Panthers, and stay dry.
Hey, what's up, Panthers? This is Andrew Menard from the Varsity Boys basketball team, and I'm just here to tell you that our first home game of the season is tonight at 7:30 against Long Beach Millican. It's going to be a great game, so make sure you come out, care about your school, and support the school. It's Friday night, no excuses. If you got homework, do it tomorrow. Anyways, we need you guys and we need the zoo, so come out and help us win. I'll see you there at 7:15.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell swing and jingle bell ring. Snowing and blowing have oceans of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell chime and jingle bell time.
Yes!
Are we good? We need to do that again. Do it again.
What?
What?
Everything's good?
Oh, yes!